Okay, hello. Today we're going to make circuit boards like this or like this and show you how we can do the print and etch technique to do that. First, we're going to need a photo tool. A photo tool is the tool that we'll use to expose the copper. To do that, we'll start with a printout from a program such as DipTrace or Eagle, and it will just be a laser printed printout of our circuit design. Here I have four of them together. I'm going to come over to our light source. I'm going to take some photographic film. I have a piece of photographic film, and we have an intense light source, and I'll put the image of the circuit boards, which are printed on white paper, which is somewhat translucent, put that down against the intense light source, the photographic film over that, and then turn on the light source so that it exposes the film through the dark and light contrast of the laser printout. Once the correct exposure has been applied to the photographic film, we'll take it through a few chemical steps to develop. First, the photographic developer solution is going to enhance the image. It's created by light hitting particles on the photo paper. We're going to put it in a stop bath, which will stop the developing process because we don't want it to develop any further. Then we will fix the chemical with the chemical fixer applied to the film in this next step. And then finally, when the fixing is done and the image is stabilized, we will then finally rinse it in clean water. Then we will hang the film up to dry. And so here is our completed photo tool that's now all completely developed and dried. We'll use that in the next part of the process to make our circuit board. To make our circuit board, we're going to start with bare two-sided FR4 board. This will need to be cleaned really well and scoured to remove fingerprints, dirt, dust, defects, and then rinsed off really well. And then I put it into the drying oven for about 15-20 minutes to fully dry the FR4 board. Now we're going to take that clean surfaces of our FR4 board and put them in the photoresist laminator. Photoresist will be the light sensitive material that we add to the surface of the board so that it is reactive to UV light when we use our photo tool. Photoresist applies a thin film of the photoresist onto the surface and then applies a protective plastic coating over that. Use this handy cutter. So I've trimmed the photoresist excess off, and now we just have photoresist applied to the FR4 board. And now it's ready for using with UV light and our photo tool that we prepared, photographic film. And we'll put that in the UV light table with the film against the light tubes and the photoresist side of the FR4 board down, and we'll turn that on for 90 seconds. See the UV light exposing film. So now that our UV light exposure for the prescribed amount of time is complete, 90 seconds, we'll put our photo tool away to keep safe and relatively clean. And now we have exposed the photoresist. And so now I will peel off the protective plastic coating so that we can expose it to the chemical solution. Okay, so we have our photoresist exposed with the UV light. I put it on a sample holder, and now I'll put it in the developer solution. I'm going to go for 50 seconds. Our 50 seconds is done. We'll take the board out of the developer solution, rinse it off, and we can see that photoresist that has been exposed to the UV light remains where all the traces and pads were, and it has been dissolved away from the rest.
Now I'm going to go in the etching solution. Etching process lasts from about 2 to 3 minutes. So the etching chemicals have been preheated and the ammonium sulfate, and it's going to hopefully dissolve away copper anywhere where there's no photoresist. So time is up on the etching process. Let's check it out. And it looks like our etching process is somewhat complete. Most of the copper removed. That means we'll have to put it in for a little longer to be more complete. Depends on the concentration of the etching and how used up the etching chemicals are. Okay, etching process is complete. Rinse off in the water. And now we have used the etching to remove the copper from everywhere where there is not the exposed photoresist. And so now we have copper everywhere where we have traces and pads where we want them. We can now trim the boards down. There are several here. We'll trim them down to size, drill holes, solder plate, and so forth. Yeah, but this is the main portion of how to use print and etch technique to make a circuit board here at Cal Poly.